So this is, can you really go off-roading in a Jeep Renegade? We're about to try it. I've got Melanie from Be Car Chick and Jim Morrison from Jeep, and we're taking this baby into some muddy stuff.
It's good plate.
We're just dragging.
Okay.
That's good.
This is some slushy stuff.
Yeah, we're in some good tracks.
If it were dry out here, this wouldn't be as fun, that's for sure.
Yeah, only the Jeep guys were praying for rain last week. Everybody else was hoping it would be nice and sunny, but I actually like it when it turns wet.
Well, I had this car about a month ago, and the only thing I didn't get to test out was, you know, these kinds of conditions.
Well, this is perfect in LA. It gets a chance to have a recent experience with an on-road, and then now we're going to go through about 20 inches of water up here.
I think
really you have to go looking for it.
Yeah.
Hopefully you don't find this in your everyday commute.
Well, I grew up in Western North Carolina, so we did stuff like this for fun.
Oh, yeah?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, that's great.
You'd see kids come to school and their trucks would be all muddy. They'd just go in the morning, go mudding somewhere.
In the sandhill.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. They want to take us up the rock?
Oh, yeah. That's next.
Yeah, this is fantastic for Jeep.
Okay.
All right.
Tire placement is everything.
Yeah.
All right.
Whoa.
Good job, Dan.
Nice.
That was tricky. After lunch, they're going to take some of this mud and give us facial.
Excellent.
Spa treatment.
Why just the facial? Why not just like a complete
a
immersion?
Whole bath.
Yeah, a whole bath.
We could do that.
You know, I've got a reason not to in a minute. You'll, when you get through this mud, you'll smell it. I'm not sure.
It has a certain sort of essence.
Yeah. It's going to do a good job at repulsing the opposite sex. You want to keep this mud in the outside.
Oh my goodness. You couldn't have created this if you wanted to.
No.
This is awesome.
Yeah, 2 days of rain.
Oh my goodness.
Come on, Bessie.
Yeah, I smell that, like you said. You might have been sitting there for a little while.
Yes. Now, it might be wonderful things for your complexion, but it might be worse.
Not for your dating life.
No. Depends what you want to do with your mud bath.
How are you?
Good, how we doing?
Good. So keep it really slow and really far to the right until you get to the log.
Okay.
See the bushy part right there on the right side of the trail? Almost like in the middle of the turn there, the apex of the turn? There's a rock just before that. You see the rock on the right?
Yeah.
Okay. So you drive right over that rock, but it's very important that you stay on the gas and that you don't turn the steering wheel.
Okay.
Have any big turns in the steering wheel, you're gonna be backing down.
Okay.
And if you start to spin, just give it a little shake of the steering wheel. Just back and forth.
Shake.
Keep steady with the gas, shake that steering wheel, and you should climb right up. But just keep it really slow until that log, so you don't end up down there.
Slow into the log,
and then
go straight for the rock?
Once you get to that log, I want you to start building up some momentum. Don't mat it, just start to build some momentum.
But aim to put the right tire onto
the rock, to the right of the rock. The most important thing is that you don't turn the steering wheel.
Got it.
If you slide a little bit.
Got it.
Okay, have fun.
Dan, I'm gonna get you to put it in rock mode.
Okay.
I got you covered. Where's the rock?
It's in the rut right on the right hand side. You can see there. A little more
okay, I see it now.
A little more pedal down.
All right, like a champ.
Nicely done.
You're going to enjoy looking at your facial expressions when you watch this video back.
And that, see, that's a really good example of how we call it AccuTrack, because it actively manages the torque.
Yeah.
And it moves the torque around. You can
hear it.
Needs
to go.
You know, one wheel starts to spin too fast. We slow down that wheel, but then we move the torque. Some of the competitive stuff just turns off the wheel speed, but they don't move the torque.
Mm.
It's a Jeep, so it needs to move the torque around. And you can feel it keep pushing the Jeep up that hill.
Yeah. So we were talking before the rock challenge about strategy when you've got like a big section of water like this. Are you better to kind of creep through it or have a little momentum?
Depending on the depth of the water, but so let's say this Jeep tops out around 20 inches. The Wrangler in front of us can do about 30 inches.
Mm-hmm.
So what you want to do is get a little bit of a bow wave going, and you want to push the water
okay.
out ahead of you, and you want to go just fast enough so that you keep all the momentum and that bow wave moving ahead of you,
mm-hmm.
and then but not too fast so that you're sucking the water into the grill.
Okay.
So just slow enough to kind of keep the momentum going and fast enough to keep the kind of the bow wave going. When
yeah.
you get in that much water, you can actually see the wave going.
Yeah.
A lot of people go into water too fast. It's good. It's dramatic for pictures and stuff.
It's good for the shot.
but you don't want to do that over a long water flow.
Okay.
So, what's neat is that is actually the hardest part of the course.
Sorry about that.
No, it's okay.
For some other vehicles, but this vehicle is so maneuverable.
Small.
Yeah.
It's small. You know, you saw the Wrangler do it. Nice job of it. But any of the vehicles that get too much bigger than the Wrangler have a hard time getting through.
The wheels are so muddy.
The Renegade just kind of wheeled on through.
Hanging a left. Ooh. Good job.
Yeah, you can tell Dan's done this before.
We're still in rock mode.
No.
Just keep going. Keep the wheel speed going. Keep your foot in it. Pull it up.
There you go. Thank you. Good insurance.
I trusted you. I wouldn't have. I'd have been climbing.
You're in the back. Climbing the tree.
Man, I need to shower now.
That was
now.
Good.
That was great. That was a
that
little
was a
nervous.
Legit experiment.
That was fantastic.
Well, so Melanie, let me ask you this. Did you, after spending time with it in the real world, did you expect that this car would do that?
Well, I know Jeep's reputation for, you know, the trail rating, so I've felt confident, but I don't think that I would expect to find myself
to
in
that
situation with the Renegade and be successful.
On these tires, on just like street tires.
Yeah, that's true, because they're not even big smoking tires.
Are they BFGs on this as well?
These have Firestones.
Do we need to be in rock mode for this log?
It's okay.
Okay.
It could be, but it'll be fine. The thing with mud is it starts it out in second gear.
Okay.
So there's a little bit less torque to the ground.
That's
fairly
easy.
But since we're rolling anyway, then it's fine. But that's the main difference between mud.
Oh, okay, because rock is like standstill pretty much when you're climbing. Now we clean off the wheels and the grass, kind of. That was fun.
That was absolutely awesome.
That was worth the drive on here just for the little ditty.
So can Renegade go off-roading?
Yes.